Hello and welcome to this video. Today I want to talk with you about pybricks and about a few updates that pybricks got in the past few months. So let's get started. First of all, pybricks is an option to program Python code. So you can use this editor to program Python. You can import stuff and so on. And then you can download the programs to the powered up hubs. And you can store the programs on the powered up hubs, which means that you can download one program at a time to the Control Plus Technic hub, to the LEGO Boost hub, and to the LEGO City hub. And they are stored on the hubs, and you can execute them locally without the need for a computer. You need a computer to program the program, you need a computer to download the program once, but you can run it locally without a computer as soon as it was copied to the hub. And a similar feature will come to the powered up app this year. It will be called powered up VM, and you will be able to download powered up code from the powered up app to the hubs, but this is an option to program Python for the hubs, and it already works. And this is the editor. It's the web editor. It's suggested to use Google Chrome for the program. There are a few important things. First, you can write our program here. We can open the documentation here. It lists commands and stuff like that. So it's pretty helpful. I think that support for the prime and inventor hubs is experimental. But in my personal opinion, pybricks is best for these three hubs because you can use the official software to program these in Python, the prime hub and the inventor hub. So pybricks, in my opinion, is mainly for the other hubs, for the move hub, for the city hub, and for the technic hub, to program them and to store programs persistently on these hubs. So here you can find the commands to control the stuff. There's also a full documentation, which you can find here. It lists all of the devices and so on. And then there's this option menu. You can open it and you can hide the documentation. You can go into the light mode. But the most important feature is this. To use pybricks, you have to download a new firmware to the hubs. You can do it with this button. You can press on it and then you can press the green button on the hub for a few seconds. The lights will start to blink purple and then you can update their firmware to the pybricks firmware. And then you can write your code. You can try it. And you can connect the hub via Bluetooth if it has the pybricks firmware. But then you want to store the program on the hub when you're finished. And to do that, you can enable this and then the program will be included in the firmware. So then you can go back into the update mode of the hub. So you can press the green button until it starts to blink purple. Then you can press this and the code that you write here will be included in this download. And you can run it if you start the hub and then press the green button again, then the code will be executed. That's basically how you use pybricks. You can go back to the normal firmware of the hub if you connect it to the powered up app. So you can go back into the update mode. You can press the button until it starts to blink. And then you can try to connect to the hub with the powered up app. And then the powered up app will update the firmware. One small note for the city hub, because you have to disconnect the cables from that one in order to update. And then there's even a little bit more, because in the settings menu on Chrome, you can install the app, you can install the offline use, and then you have the pybricks code IDE stored on your computer. So you can use this editor offline. You don't need an internet connection to program your stuff. And I think that's pretty cool. And this is an example code. You need to import the libraries and then you can write your code. That's Python code. But anyways, that was it for this video. Please tell me in the comments if you are going to try pybricks out and if you're interested in pybricks. Anyways, thanks for watching this far. See you in the next video and bye.